In the news, the Republican presidential candidates took on the economy, foreign policy, and each other as they had some very sharp disagreements in last night's presidential debate. David Brody brings us the story from Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
You were against putting troops on
the GOP candidates sparred in their most substantive debate so far in this election cycle, with the economy taking center stage, from discussing the tax code.
The current system isn't fair. Washington is fundamentally corrupt. There are more words in the IRS code than there are in the Bible. And not a one of them is as good.
To building a stronger middle class.
For the life of me, I don't know why we have stigmatized vocational education. Welders make more money than philosophers. We need more welders and less philosophers.
The biggest clash came when Rand Paul questioned Marco Rubio's desire to push for a larger child tax credit in addition to more defense spending.
The point that I'd like to make about the tax credits, we have to decide what is conservative and what isn't conservative. Is it fiscally conservative to have $1 trillion expenditure?
And yes, I do want to rebuild the American military.
How is it conservative?
I know that Rand is a committed isolationist. I'm not. I believe the world is a stronger and a better place when the United States is the strongest military power in the world.
Marco, how is it conservative? How is it conservative to add $1 trillion expenditure for the federal government?
There were also disagreements on topics like immigration. Trump wants to deport all illegal immigrants.
We either have a country or we don't have a country. We are a country of laws. Going to have to go out, and they'll come back, but they're going to have to go out, and hopefully they get back.
But if people think that we are going to ship 11 million people who are law-abiding, who are in this country, and somehow pick them up at their house and ship them out of Mexico, think about the families. Think about the children. It's a silly argument. It's not an adult argument. It makes no
sense.
All
I can say.
On foreign policy, Trump believes we should stay out of Syria and let Vladimir Putin and Russian forces fight over there.
We can't continue to be the policemen of the world.
Donald is wrong on this. He is absolutely wrong on this. We're not going to be the world's policeman, but we sure as heck better be the world's leader. There's a huge difference where, without us leading, voids are filled.
Carly Fiorina took the opportunity to say how she would show Putin America's muscle.
I would start rebuilding the Sixth Fleet right under his nose, rebuilding the military, the missile defense program in Poland right under his nose. I would conduct very aggressive military exercises in the Baltic states so that he understood we would protect our NATO allies and would-be allies.
As for top-tier candidate Ben Carson, he addressed the swirling controversy over the media vetting process and how they're trying to find any little thing to take him down.
So I have no problem with being vetted. What I do have a problem with is being lied about. But, you know, when I look at somebody like Hillary Clinton, who sits there and tells her daughter and a government official that, no, this was a terrorist attack, and then tells everybody else that it was a video, where I came from, they call that a lie.
Now that this debate in Milwaukee is complete, the next one comes more than a month from now in Las Vegas in mid-December. And in this presidential race that's turned into a soap opera, that gives plenty of time for a lot of twists and turns. David Brody, CBN News in Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Thanks, David. I don't know how many of you watched that debate, but I think that the guys from Fox and the editor of the Wall Street Journal were superb. Moderators. They brought in a lot of substance, and they gave the guys a chance to really discuss these issues that are very important to the American people. And I frankly think all of the Republicans did well. I think as a group, they acquitted themselves very admirably. And so what the American people are saying here is a team of men and one woman who are capable of being the next president or vice president or secretary of state or whatever. And I think the brand of Republicanism is going up because of debates like this. And the one with the CNBC's was a disaster. But this one was very well done, and I commend them.